Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today I have a great idea for when you have to create a worksheet that you're going to send out to someone else to fill out. I used to have to send a worksheet out to a sales force of 50 sales reps, and if I sent this to 50 sales reps, they would find at least 8 different ways to spell the word northeast. It drove me crazy when I got all the spreadsheets back and I had to try and compile them to have all of the same values basically spelled a different way. And we can overcome that, plus make the spreadsheet easier for the person to use using something called data validation. And what it does is it basically adds a drop down right to the cell. So if this is a cell where I want them to enter a district value, I can select that cell and then go to data validation. Now it turns out that every single cell in Excel is set up with a validation rule that currently says we're going to allow any value, but you can change that and say that the values are going to come from a list. Once we have a list, a new box pops up where we can show the source. Click in the source box, and then off on the right-hand side of your spreadsheet where no one will see, have a list of the valid values. I'm going to select those and then click OK. Now, as soon as I go in and select that cell, it gives me a drop-down with all the valid values. Hopefully, the people that you're sending the spreadsheet to will take advantage of the drop-down and choose from the list. Now, if they're stubborn and they decide to try and enter something on their own, like N period, E period, Excel won't let them enter that value. Hey, there you have it. You can use data validation to add a drop-down list right to the worksheet to make the worksheets easier to use and also ensure that the values that you get back are consistent from worksheet to worksheet. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.